fancy behavior. You know, if I have the function is squared, I say that s is s prime cubed, then the function becomes s prime to the sixth. So you plug the golden transformation inside the function. The first derivatives of your scalar field will transform like one forms. So there will be some Jacobian. So this is all pretty uncontroversial. Now what happens to the stress tensor? So this part transforms fine. So you get one of the Jacobian factors here, one here, no problem. But this part does not transform very nicely, right? So it means that if I try to understand how the stress tensor, the quantum stress tensor is related in some coordinate system or in some other coordinate system. So I will do guess something like this prime over ds squared, which comes from this transformation. But I need to do something about that. So in a sense, you get something like this. You get, let me make sure that too many primes. Let me call this new coordinate tilde. Okay, I'm sure like the algebra a little bit wrong, but bear with me. I would like to say that I should get something like this. But I need a limit. S prime to S. I get something else, tilde over the S. There's tilde prime or S prime. 1 over S tilde minus tilde prime squared minus 1 over S minus S squared. Oops. Now, the divergence of these two functions is actually the same. So the difference is finite. So defined, but it's not zero. So feel free to take this, expand it in powers of S prime minus S, and see what you get. You get some ugly looking expression. It's called the Schwarzian derivative of S tilde. So after you get something like this. I just write it as now, so you see, the stress tensor is not transforming quite right. Okay, you say, okay, whatever. What is that? See, the stress is supposed to be the change in your correlation function, superposition function, when you change the metric. See, so if I change my metric by some delta h, AB, the effect on partition function or correlation function should be the same as inserting an ATAB del H AB inside. Now, if I try to write this in different coordinate systems, you know how the metric changes? It has some Jacobian, which is exactly the opposite of this. So this is fine, but this one is not. So you see that somehow you get some tension, some slight problem with coordinate changes of coordinates. Now, when I say changes of coordinates, these are really changes of coordinates together with the wild transformation, because here I did a calculation in some holomorphic, you know, essentially with a flat metric, and I'm using, in fact, a change of coordinates and then a wild transformation to go back to flat metric. So this number here, depends on this term, it encodes part of the problems that this theory has with wild symmetry. So it's actually possible to argue that, you know, whatever classical theory, which is classically by one firm of Fisher and Wagen, is going to have ones that look like this, with some different number here, called the central charge. So here, so this coordinate scalar field has a problem of magnitude 1, with wild symmetry. Now this pops up in a lot of places, although to see why we had to think about it better in some other lecture. The fact that here it knows you have mean energy is also tied into that. And there's another nice application of this, which is the last thing I want to do today, actually. Admittedly, we're a bit short on time, but so yeah, by the way, so this sort of expression over there, I could also written by saying that t is minus 1/2 the naive normal ordering minus 1 over L squared. See, the naive normal order two-point function is something that, especially by definition, gives you zero once you put it in the expectation value. And it's minus 1 over 24 accounts for the difference. So if you actually expand this stress tensor in Fourier modes, you get something like this. Okay. is a convenient to the notice like this. So these are three modes of the stress tensor. As I mentioned up there, these three modes are actually the constant charges of some symmetries. I'll leave the discussion of what symmetries those are for later, but they're roughly covariant transformations, complex covariant transformations. All I wanted to do in the remaining 20 seconds is to compute the algebra satisfied by these modes. Okay. Now, you can do it directly from the definition, but there are some infinite sums that are a little bit bothersome. A nice way to do it is to first compute how these modes act on the operators, like stress tensor, like phi, like x, and then expand operators in Fourier modes. Yes? Sorry, you're right. Normal order of an am is an am if am is positive, and am and if m is negative. Yes?
But we still have the zero modes.
I was being too much in a hurry. I forgot to give us a definition. You see, because of that expansion of the current over there, it's actually convenient to define a zero equal to p, and a zero bar equal to minus p. But here was a contribution from p. For example, if you look at L zero, this for p, it's something like p squared over 2. So L0, j is 0 minus 1 over 24 is the energy of your state. Now, first of all, you can start from the definition and check that ln a m gives you m a n plus m. Okay. In particular, L0 measures the energy.